Okay, I'm at 19550 North Greyhawk Drive, unit 1044, two-car garage. Look at the street. There's the garage spot, the open garage. We'll go around to the front door. Entry, and right as you come in to the left, you have a small half bath. Back up to the foyer again, go a little bit further in. You have kind of this office den, which is pretty small. I'm going to say it's probably a 10 by 12 room, but almost part of it cut off here. French doors, but it would be pretty tough to fit a bed and dresser in here. No closet. Might be able to get a day bed along this wall here. Back up a little bit so you get an idea of how big this is. Pretty small room. And if I go back to the foyer, turn, you can see the stairs are going to be right to my right. And then I have a coat closet, which kind of wraps under the stairs a bit. Pretty good amount of storage. And then if I were to go left, we would be right into the kitchen. So, nice kitchen, nice gas stove. Bar top with dining just past. If I continue through the kitchen, KitchenAid fridge, pantry, laundry, which leads to the two-car garage. Which is a pretty good size. And then do you have a storage closet in here, which is probably about a, I'd say, 4x6, but good size two-car garage, water softener, looks like a fairly new gas water heater. We go back inside. Living area. And then you do have the tall ceilings here. Which does help the size, feel the size. Fireplace. But again, not a huge living space here. You have, I would say, about a 12 by 16 living area, broken off with the wood floor. And then dining. So the dining space is actually about the same size, if not bigger, than the living room. So this here, you got about, I should say about a 15 by 15 dining room area. And out here is the patio. This I measured to be 10 by 11 as far as the size between the pillar, this wall, the outer wall, and your Arcadia door. Then this wall here, I would say is probably just about 3.5 feet, so it's not a super tall wall. But you are pretty private as far as the landscaping goes, or the wash area, I should say. That helps with the privacy. And then you are on the end as far as the building goes. And then if we were to go back inside, let's see, they have stools at the bar and still room for the dining set. So that is the whole first floor. Now if we go upstairs, you have the guest bedroom on the left. It's like a queen bed. Ceiling fan. So, decent size room. I'd say maybe 11 by 13. Slider closet. Walk-in bath. So your standard shower tub combo. Then we have a little linen closet right outside the door. Look from above. And then the master. So it's like we have a full king. Still a good amount of space on each side. And then a good amount of space to the TV. Let's say you got between the bed and the wall, you got about 7 or 8 feet there. Garden tub, double sinks, water closet, and then good size walk-in. This is probably about 8 by 8 or so. So lots of storage space in the closet. And then just kind of your standard shower setup. Go out to the patio. The patio is a decent size. Some nice views from above. And then size wise, you got almost 20 feet from the very end here. About 15 workable, and then you have almost 6 feet across. And this does kind of wrap around, as you can see, over the AC units.